Welcome back to our Planet Ayurveda studio. We are here with Dr. Shumbul and Dr. Ranjana discussing how to maintain healthy and rich hair today.
Yeah, so everyone knows that it's a trend for the long hairs, and I personally feel if I am getting long hairs, and nowadays because of pollution and outside dirt and particles, our hair fall is there. So for that, we have to just take some extra nutrients. We have to give some extra care to our hairs, so to maintain a healthy hairs. For that, we are having a in baldness. Like if the person is not having a hairs or any baldness is there, so you can just take an onion and make it in slices or grind in a mixture. Take the onion juice, make add some lemon in it, and apply it over the scalp. Just keep it for 10 to 15 minutes and then wash it off. Though onion smell is very, pathetic. Nobody wants to apply onion, but for the rich hairs, we have to apply it. Because it doesn't smell, only go for after washing it. So that onion we are having, and then we are having a aloe vera. Aloe vera, you just take aloe vera and you just cut it off, and you just pulp, aloe vera pulp, you can take it and massage it over your hairs. And it will give you shiny hairs, because I also doing that, and that's a pulp, you just massage over the hairs, leave it for the 10 minutes and then wash it off. Don't apply some shampoos just after it, just take it short, just with a plain water, and after 2 to 3 days just apply the shampoo, okay? Mm-hmm. And next...
you can also apply apple cider vinegar, as it manages the pH of the scalp. And also increases, enhances the growth of the hair from the follicles. So you can apply over the scalp and just wash it after 10 to 15 minutes. It also helps for the hair.
It is healthy. It gives you shiny, because of the upper side of the vinegar. It gives you shiny hairs. Like if you are having dry hairs, rough hairs, so it will provide the shine to the hairs. Mm-hmm. And moreover, we are having egg yolk marks. In nowadays, the shampoos, they are claiming that we are having egg. Content in it. You just don't go for that shampoos, because it also having chemicals and all. You just make a mask of egg white. Just take egg white. Just
it is rich in protein.
Yeah, also. It is rich in very protein. So just apply egg mask over it, and just keep it for 5-10 minutes, and just do this therapy one or twice a week. It will give you rich hairs with protein, full of protein, means it will provide proteins to the hairs, mm-hmm. and it will for the healthy hairs. And moreover,
it makes amla is also very rich in vitamin C and antioxidants. So if you take it internally or apply it externally, making it paste or mask, it is also very helpful in hair growth.
Like coconut milk, that is also rich in iron, potassium. Mm-hmm. So they just take a coconut, grind it, and have a coconut milk. You just wash your hairs with the coconut milk. It is very good for the healthy skin. Mm-hmm. Healthy hairs. Mm-hmm. Like it gives you if you have any hair fall problem. So for that, coconut oil is very good. Mm-hmm. You just before washing your hair, after trying, just have a massage with coconut oil. Mm-hmm. You just keep it for 1 to 2 hours and then wash your hairs. It will give moreover with the shampoos, your roughness, dryness will come now. So it does the coconut oil maintain the moisture in your hairs. So that's why we are always recommending to apply a coconut oil massage before washing your hairs.
Fenugreek is also really helpful as it contains.
Fenugreek.
It is rich in nicotinic acid and protein. So if you make powder, if you powder it and mix it with some
rose water, honey, you
and
can
apply
it
over the scalp and leave it for 15 to 20 minutes, and then just shampoo from the mild or some herbal shampoo. It will help with the hair growth.
Yeah.
Would fenugreek work also if they can internally?
Yeah, definitely it will work. As I told you, it is rich in protein and nicotinic acid, which is very good for hair growth. So it will work.
Just have fenugreek seeds and just soak it in water for overnight, and just have in the morning you just strain the water and have it, the fenugreek water. That is also good for the skin, also moreover for the hairs also. So just have this habit of taking fenugreek water daily. So you can take it, and we all know that Chinese, like, they are having very smooth and shiny hairs, and everyone want to look like we should have smooth, shiny hairs. For that, nowadays they are having keratin therapy, some reboning is there. Which is very harmful and it's costly too. For that, you just don't go for any parlors or anything. You just have a rice water, like the water used to boil the rice. You just strain that water and just wash your hairs with the rice water.
Okay.
And just after just rinsing your hairs with the rice water, just keep it for 10 to 15 minutes and then wash it with the normal mild shampoo and herbal shampoo. You can take it, any herbal shampoo. And it will give you shiny and straight hairs. That is very good phenomena also, and moreover that your expenditure on the like a rebonding keratin has
been very cheap. Yes,
all is very cheap, and moreover in our daily meals we are boiling the rice only.
Yes.
Yeah, you just collect, and if we are taking a rice without that rice water, na, it will just normally in body also it is very good.
Yeah, because the water is full of starch.
Full of starch. If you take out the starch and use it here, and that rice will become light and it will not give you fat on your body. So that is also good in other way also. Not it will not, if you take out the water from the rice, that will not the rice becomes so light that it will not give you fat on your body. You would be obese or anything else. So for the with one remedy you can have the two benefits, I guess. Yeah. You can have a fit body as well as you can have a shiny hair as well.
Yeah. Okay. What about these patients undergoing chemotherapy? Mm. How could we help him to raise the hair faster?
Like she said, amla is very very rich in vitamin C and antioxidants. So if the cancer patient who is going through the chemotherapy or who has been through the chemotherapy, if he or she have amla, single amla daily early in the morning, or have some amla juice, it will help it a lot.
Yeah.
In new growth.
Yeah, for the new growth of the hairs, yeah. It will help it out. Moreover, first of all, we are not recommending to take amla when the chemotherapy is going on, because it has a side effect of chemotherapy, hair fall is will be there. And if one guesses like if we will not have a hair fall during chemotherapy, that is not that is wrong, because that is a natural process. Like for the chemotherapy side effect, we will have a hair fall, but after once the chemotherapy will be stopped, then we can start with the amla or amla keel, and it will be helpful for growing in new hairs, and for the healthy hairs it will be good for the chemotherapy patient and for the cancer patient also.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.